The field and its knower, Arjuna said, what are nature and self? What are the field and its knower, knowledge and the object of knowledge? Teach me about them, Krishna. The Blessed Lord said, this body is called the field. Arjuna, the one who watches whatever happens within it, wise men call him the knower. I am the knower of the field in every body, Arjuna. Genuine knowledge means knowing both the field and its knower. Listen, and I will explain the nature of the field, what changes take place in it, who is the knower, and what his great powers are. The sages have sung of these truths in the sacred hymns and in many powerful and well-argued reasonings about God. The five elements, the eye sense, the understanding, the ten senses, the mind, the unmanifest, and the five domains of the senses, desire and aversion, pleasure and pain, consciousness, will, all these components make up the field with its various changes. Humility, patience, sincerity, nonviolence, uprightness, purity, devotion to one's spiritual teacher, constancy, self-control, dispassion toward objects of the senses, freedom from the eye sense, insight into the evils of birth, sickness, old age, and death, detachment, absence of clinging to son, wife, family, and home, and unshakable equanimity in good fortune or in bad, an unwavering devotion to me above all things, an intense love of solitude, distaste for involvement in worldly affairs, persistence in knowing the self, and awareness of the goal of knowing. All this is called true knowledge. What discerns, what differs from it is called ignorance. I will teach you what should be known. Knowing it, you are immortal. It is the supreme reality, which transcends both being and non-being. Its hands and its feet are everywhere. Everywhere its eyes, heads, mouths. Everywhere its ears. It dwells in all worlds, containing all things. Though lacking senses itself, it shines through the working of the senses, unattached, all-sustaining, experiencing the jhanas yet above them. Outside yet within all beings, motionless, always moving, subtle beyond comprehension, far yet nearer than near. And so it is.